In brain photobiomodulation, one of the key questions is, which near-infrared wavelength works best? This video compares three leading wavelengths, 810, 1064, and 1070 nanometers, and how they differ in their effects on the brain, along with another vital aspect, irradiance, the intensity of light energy. For light to reach brain cells, it must pass through difficult barriers, such as the skin and skull, which cause absorption and scattering. According to the body's optical window, water absorption rises sharply above 1,000 nanometers. This means 810 nanometers is absorbed less by water comparatively, which is abundant in the human body, especially the brain. Research from both Harvard Medical School and Peking Medical University allude to this, showing that 810 nanometers provides deeper and stronger energy delivery than 1064 nanometers. However, while 1064 and 1070 nanometers lose more energy to water, they scatter less, and some other simulations suggest this may allow for deeper penetration. Therefore, the question of deeper penetration is not as simple as longer equals better. Different studies examine different conditions and methods, which is why Harvard Medical School favors 810 nanometers, while others emphasize 1064 nanometers. What about the cellular effects? Inside brain cells, mitochondria produce energy through an enzyme called cytochrome-c-Oxidase. CCO's ability to absorb photons peaks near 810 nanometers, making this wavelength the mitochondrial sweet spot for efficient ATP production and cellular energy metabolism. This supports neuronal energy metabolism, encourages healthy cerebral blood flow, and engages proplasticity signaling. At 1064 and 1070 nanometers, coupling to CCO is weaker, but these wavelengths interact more directly with heat-sensitive ion channels. This localized effect can trigger calcium influx, supporting processes like neurotransmitter release, gene expression, and even neurogenesis. None of these wavelength differences matter without sufficient irradiance, the intensity of light energy. If the irradiance is too low, light won't reach brain tissue in meaningful amounts, no matter the wavelength. This demonstration uses a CMOS camera to compare light penetration through a real human skull at two different wavelengths, 810 nanometers from the Vielight Neuro Pro 2 and 1070 nanometers from a Neuronic helmet. The CMOS camera detects near-infrared light, which is normally invisible to the human eye, but critical in photobiomodulation. As the video shows, the 1070 nanometer light struggles to pass through the skull. In contrast, the 810 nanometer light from the Neuro Pro 2 penetrates more effectively, making the difference in performance visually apparent. A 2024 systematic review of over 2,000 brain photobiomodulation studies found that the most frequent parameters in effective studies were an irradiance of approximately 250 milliwatts per square centimeter, the 810 nanometer wavelength, and lasers. With our highly engineered VLED technology, we simulate the irradiance of lasers with the safety of LEDs, leading to optimal outcomes. In summary, 810, 1064, and 1070 nanometers are used in brain PBM. 810 nanometers strongly targets mitochondria and shows consistent cognitive and neuroprotective benefits. 1064 and 1070 nanometers scatter less and can activate ion channels, offering a more experimental route to neuromodulation. Vielight uses 810 nanometers because it is supported by the most published brain PBM studies, penetrates efficiently through scalp and skull, while strongly stimulating mitochondrial pathways. In the end, effective PBM depends on the right mix of wavelength, irradiance, and delivery.